When most people think of British Columbia's coastal temperate rainforest, they're probably not thinking of a forest that looks quite like this. Welcome to the bog forest. From a timber point of view, these ecosystems couldn't grow a tree to save their life. And yet there's a whole bunch of species that we only find in bogs and bog woodlands. Most bogs are primarily resting on a bed of sphagnum. The sphagnum occupies perhaps more of the earth's surface than any other plant. These little mosses here have a remarkable water-holding capability, primarily because of their structure. If you look at them microscopically, they have a relatively small number of living cells surrounded by a number of dead cells. And that means that the sphagnum plant itself can absorb rather a large amount of water compared with any other plant. This particular shrub here, Labrador Tea, has leaves with a very pungent and delicious smell to them. If you're ever wondering, crush a leaf between your fingers and have a sniff. And once you've smelled Labrador Tea, you won't ever confuse this shrub with anything else. The leaves can be dried and used to make a tea that a lot of people enjoy in moderation. There are some mild toxins in the plant, but I find it's a perfectly palatable beverage that is a really good aid to sleep after a hard day's work. Shore pine is our coastal variety of lodgepole pine. It's generally of shorter stature and is really common and widespread in bogs and bog forests. It's similar to the species which is widespread across the interior of British Columbia, only on the coast it's got shorter needles and is generally a tree of shorter stature. It's an extreme environment. You know, if you had deep roots here, it wouldn't be much of a problem. But there's no way that any of these plants can have deep roots when the water table's up near the surface for a good part of the year. Yeah, so we've excavated the roots of some of the pines here just to have a look at them. And yeah, 10 centimeters would be fairly deep for pine roots around here. So it's a very slow growing tree in these sorts of environments. Sometimes some of these shore pine that we find that you might think are relatively young might be a century or more old. This sweetgale here is another plant we associate with wetlands. It has separate male and female plants, which is quite unusual for the plants around here. And those plants can actually switch during their lifetime from being male to female or back. The female plants produce flowers and fruits which are remarkably fragrant, which is where the name sweetgale comes from. And this is the sticky false asphodel, and it has stems which are really quite tacky or sticky. Don't know if you can see that, but as I stretch my fingers away from the stem, it's actually sticking to my fingers. And is a beautiful wetland plant that can be quite abundant in our bogs. It's assumed that the stickiness is some kind of a defense against insects eating it, trying to chomp down on the stem, similar to what other plants do with scales or thorns. Yeah, we could use that to stick my mic on. That'd probably be better than this sticky tape. These bogs and bog forests are the characteristic ecosystems of much of central and north coast British Columbia and southeast Alaska. This is what the rainforest looks like over a lot of that area. These distinctive ecosystems are important, critical components of biodiversity in our coastal landscapes in British Columbia.